Hello guys, I'm Peter from Build a Boeing. Happy New Year. New Year's Eve is just a few days away, so I thought it would be a good idea to make a status of the cockpit of 2017, the year that was supposed to be the big rebuild, but that quite didn't happen. If you look around, you can see I'm not in any way finished. I'm having issues, not personal issues, but with the build. But let me just go through from top down what's been going on and some of the reasons I haven't done as much as I hoped this year. First of all, I started making a curved screen, 180 degrees curved screen with two projectors. But the image quality just wasn't good enough. So I had to get a third one. Mind you, these are not full HD. These are 1200 x 800 in resolution. And that, of course, has an influence on image quality. But for me, I had to use three to get a picture where I can read taxi signs. But now it looks okay. Next up, I bought the Flylease Display Pro program. And I'm now having problems with the calibration. Of course, I can manually calibrate them, but I need to make an overlap between the screens. You can see right there where they meet. And I'm not able to do that in the Display Pro program. I can calibrate them so that they join right there, but I'm not able to calibrate them with an overlap so I can blend the picture so it looks perfect. And I talked to the guys in the Netherlands and they said I need to buy an additional piece of software that costs 180 euros. I might take that plunge later on, but not right now. The bend right there, of course, is my manual calibration that isn't good enough. That will have to come at a later point. Furthermore, my old graphic card stops working now and then. So luckily, I got a new one from my wife in Christmas gift. The not so lucky part was I wrote down the wrong numbers. So I'm exchanging it right now and hoping it will come in a few days. But I'm gonna install its 1060 card in a few days. And hopefully that will improve the image quality even more. This is gonna work at some point, I'm sure about it, but that three projector solution and a curved screen, I love it. Then I mounted my overhead, and in the process, I started building the Simajaps shell as one of the first things. I thought, this time I'm gonna build a shell, and then I'm gonna mount the cockpit into it. But a few times, I've found the Simajaps shell not to have the right measurements. And once again, that happened here. Where you see that crossbar, that is where the overhead is supposed to be if you use the Marcus Pilot PDF files. Up there is where Simajaps want the overhead to be. And there's a gap here of approximately 8 centimeters. Now, 8 centimeters is quite a lot when you're sitting and have to reach back to reach these the aft overhead, so I'm going with the Marcus Pilot measurements, and my plan then is to I don't know if you've seen that German guy Michael Schulz, I think his name is. He's made some windows and sidewalls, and his finish, his quality is very good. Mine is not going to be that good, but I like the idea of making the windows and then make sidewalls, and then I can always make a roof of some sort. So that's how I'm going to do it, hopefully within 2018. While I mounted this crossbar here, I took it backwards and the overhead fell down. And it fell down on my throttle, and my throttle handles, they broke. So I had to start making new ones or see if I could fix them. And luckily I fixed them using some metal and a few screws on both sides and not having to build a new throttle. That is great. I did a video a few years ago about all the computers I have. Now I've got a new one over here, the black one there, which takes care of almost everything. It takes care of ProSim, it takes care of all the USB cards, all the interface cards, except for one, or well, actually two, my autopilot unit. This is an old returning issue. I'm not able to extend the USB wire on the autopilot unit. It's an open cockpits version 2 or 3, I can't remember. I'm not able to extend the USB wire. If I do that, it will turn off. I reckon it's because it doesn't get enough power. Then I tried to give it additional power using the socket in the back of the autopilot unit. Then it just blacks out. So I have a third computer right down there. You can see it there. With that one attached, and that computer also handles the primary flight displays. The other computer that I showed you just before, the black one over here, handles everything else. It handles ProSim, it handles vPilot, it handles all USB connectors, and it handles the upper ICAS, lower ICAS, and the FMC. And I'm having problems with the USB and power from the USB. The computer is powered from a power socket just over there, you can see it right there, and the rest of the cockpit is powered from that one over there. And this is turned off when I turn on the computer, but still I'm not able to turn on the computer unless I take out specific USB wires. But there's no power in them. I don't know why the computer will not turn on when these are connected. I have to take them out, boot up the computer, put them back in, go over there and turn on the power for the entire cockpit, including these screens. I've tried to see if there's a current. There isn't a current, so I don't know what's wrong. Furthermore, because these screens are also powered by my second power socket, they're not turning on with the computer. And so when they turn on, the computer starts putting the images on in randomly. So sometimes that's the upper ICAS, that's the lower ICAS and upper ICAS. And that is just annoying. So I'm trying to solve these problems with USB wires. But whenever I fix something, it's like something else goes wrong. Like today, these switches start flicking in ProSim, but you can see they are boxed in. There's nothing wrong. They're boxed in. Nothing has been touched in here. But they still stopped working. Yesterday, this is a Pululu card down here, and this Pululu card yesterday, that connector fell off the board. So I had to solder it back on. And that's those 0.1 inch lines. And it was quite a hassle, and even the lanes on the printed circuit board came loose at one point, so I was a bit angry yesterday. So it's like whenever I fix something, something else goes wrong, and it's not stable right now. I'm hoping to be able to make a stable setup with the USB, but it's the USB wires that's causing me problems, and I don't know why. Normally I try to keep my wires, at least I try to keep them nice and tidy, but as you can see right now, it's quite a mess. And that is, of course, because I'm taking them back and forth, in and out, seeing what to do to make it more stable. Haven't solved it yet, but that will hopefully come soon. ProSim version 2 comes out in a few days, and I've always, since I bought ProSim, been worried about what happens when version 2 comes out, because it stated pretty clearly that the license you buy is only version 1. Version 2, you have to rebuy it. But luckily, it seems that we can transfer for a monthly fee of around 10 euros, and that for me seems very reasonable, given that we are promised new development on the suite. So I'm looking very, very much forward to that. It's 3 or 4 days away, but I hope to have a stable setup before that. Okay, last thing I'd just like to show you is actually from the beginning of this film. This is my registration that I normally fly. It's a Norwegian one. And you can see down here, this model that I found. Barry has the same registration, which I think is very neat. And with that, I'd like to wish you all a happy new year. See you in 2018. Thank you for all your support. Thank you for emails, comments. It's wonderful. This is a great community. I wish you all a very happy new year. Take care. I'm Peter. For Bilderberg, bye-bye.